We are now focusing heavily on the employee experience. So we want to look at our relocation policies, not just from, let's say, a cost perspective, but also from the employee experience perspective.
What does it look like to maintain the employee experience, but maybe keep the budget where it is, or maybe even lower it some? When we're looking at the policy and the overall spend, it comes down to communication. How do we communicate with the employees? And that's kind of where I see the building block and the foundation of doing more with less is. It starts with setting the expectation, making sure that everything is communicated clearly so that the employee starts out with the correct expectation and understanding of what is the support that they're being provided with. And having that picture clear in their mind will help them, I think, be more satisfied. Really, I look at our Grable consultants as key in that. They're that first line contact with our employees who are relocating, and they're the ones who can help us set that expectation with them because they're in that daily contact with them as they're going through the process.
I feel that what's happening in the industry now is that you've got a lot of different populations moving, right? So maybe you have more younger people who are relocating who may not need that full move package. Maybe they're looking for more flexibility, so maybe a lump sum program would be more appropriate. So I feel like there's more diversity in terms of the population that's moving, and therefore the relocation policies that used to work 10 years ago just aren't as effective these days. There's a lot more out there today that can be used to enhance the employee experience, maybe even a self-service, make it easier for the employee, make it easier for the consultant, whereas maybe 10, 20 years ago, we didn't have these tools. Now we have them, let's utilize them.